Hello students, hope you are doing good. So in this lecture, okay, we'll be just discussing our throw and default catch mechanism. Okay, so in the previous lectures we have discussed default throw, default catch and default throw over catch. Okay, in which JVM is raising the exceptions and JVM's default catch mechanism is handling the exceptions. Okay, JVM is raising the exceptions and our catch handler is accessing or handling the exceptions. Okay, now in this third category we will just discuss the implementation, that how we are throwing the exceptions. Okay, our throw mechanism is there. Okay, now there is no default throw and the default catch mechanism is taking place. Okay, so in order to illustrate this, let us take an example. Okay, for example, a candidate wishes to apply for a government job. Okay, and the prerequisites of the government job is that the age of the candidate should not be greater than 30. Okay, so if the age is greater than 30, then he is not eligible for that particular job. Okay, so now we will be just implementing this concept, okay, with the help of our throw and default catch. Okay, in this we are just raising the exception. Okay, in this now Java's JVM is unaware of the exception being raised. Okay, because there is no default exception object of the Java. It is our responsibility to create our exception object. Okay, depending upon the type of the class we are creating. Okay, depending upon the type of the exception that is being raised, and the default catch mechanism will work on that. Okay, so just I am creating the class. Okay, exception 3, public static void main. Okay, this is the first entry point. Okay, now I am just creating a variable age of type integer. Okay, so I am just reading this age with the help of scanner class object. So I am creating an object of a scanner class, scanner sc is equal to new scanner. Okay, this is the syntax for creating an object of a scanner class. Okay, you must be aware of it. Okay, system dot in. Okay, so in order to use this, we have to implement, okay, what, import java dot util dot star or java dot util dot scanner, you can also write it. Okay, so this I am just importing, okay, this particular package. Okay, util is this package. Okay, in this package there are n number of classes. Okay, so I'm just using only scanner class out of it. Now what we have to do, okay, we have to now read. Okay, so what we'll do, age is equal to sc dot, if this is of type integer, then the, but what is the method? Method is next int. Okay, remember the methods. Okay, so you have to just go through the Java docs. Okay, so I am printing system dot out dot print ln. Okay, I just write this statement here. Okay, control X, enter the age of the candidate. Okay, so it will be read by this line. Okay, now what is the condition? If age is greater than 30. Okay, this is now the statement. Okay, this is now the condition. This is now the critical condition or the critical statement. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to throw the exception. Now we have to explicitly throw the particular exception. Okay, now the Java's JVM is not responsible for throwing the exception. Java's JVM is not responsible for the creation of exception object. We have to create our exception object by our own. Okay, so for this we have to write throw. Okay, this is the keyword for throwing the exception. Okay, throwing the exception explicitly. Okay, throw and the type of the exception. Okay, so it belongs to arithmetic type, arithmetic class. So arithmetic exception. Okay, so before arithmetic exception we have to also create the object of the exception of the arithmetic exception class. Okay, so how we will create the object of arithmetic exception class? By using new keyword. Okay, So new arithmetic exception. Okay, now the object of arithmetic class has been created. Arithmetic exception class's object has been created. Okay, and inside this constructor, okay, we have to create, we have to write a string. Okay, we have to write a string. Why we have to write a string? Because if we want to raise an exception by our own, then we have to write something into that exception object. Okay, so that the default catch mechanism will read, okay, that particular exception object and print the message depending upon the type we have embedded in it. Okay, so we'll just embed, okay, age, okay, invalid. Okay, for example, age invalid or age exits. Okay, age exits and not eligible now. Okay, this message we are, okay, writing inside the constructor. Okay, inside the particular object we are creating. Now in this explicit, okay, object has been created, okay, of type arithmetic exception. Okay, so an object has been created explicitly of the type arithmetic exception. So it is the class of the exception, okay, arithmetic exception, and object of this class has been now created that contains this information, this message that we have printed in the constructor of this arithmetic exception class. Got it? Okay, so in the next line I write system dot out dot println. Okay, so if this condition fails, then what happens? If the age is equal to 20, it means what we have to write? Valid age, okay, and now continue filling the form. Okay, this is certain type of message we are just writing. Okay, and we are just closing the program. Okay, so in this you can see we have not created any catch block. Okay, we have not created any catch block because there is no handler from our side. Okay, our catch block is not there. Okay, the default catch mechanism of the Java will be just catching the exception that has been raised by the user. Okay, explicitly. So this is the exception that has been raised by the user. Okay, this line, it shows that the exception object, okay, of arithmetic exception class has been created by the user explicitly that contains this particular message that will be decoded, that will be printed by the default catch mechanism of the Java. Okay, so we'll just save this particular program. Okay, control S. So the name is exception 3 dot Java. Okay, save. So I am just running it. So what is the first line? Java C exception 3 dot Java. So this is compiling, assuming the there are no syntactical errors. Okay, let's see what happens. Okay, this program has been successfully compiled. Okay, there are no errors. Okay, and exception 3 dot class file has also been generated. Okay, now we'll execute Java exception 3. Okay, so now we'll enter the age of the candidate. Okay, for example, if I enter 20, what will happen? There will be no exception raised because this condition is now false here. Okay, so what will be the output? Well, the output is valid age. Okay, and now continue filling the form. So no exception is now raised here. Okay, so now we'll be raising the exception. Okay, so age is, for example, 45. Okay, so here you can see, okay, here you can see clearly that exception in thread main java dot lang dot arithmetic exception, okay, exception has been raised. And what does it say? We have printed age exceeds and not eligible now. Okay, so the message that we have given, okay, inside the constructor in the particular exception object has now been printed here. Okay, So I hope, okay, you cleared your concept now. Okay, your concepts are cleared now. Okay, for overthrow and default catch mechanism. Okay, so practice some more live examples. Okay, think some more logical conditions. Okay, you can think of banking transaction system also. There are n number of examples. Try to implement the real world examples. Okay, so that it will be more clear to you. Okay, so that your brain will work more clearly. Okay, your logics will develop. Okay, so thank you. Okay, stay safe, stay healthy. Okay.